that we had finished last week. And tonight, bi'idhnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, we're going to be reading from our weekly class in the explanation of the pre-Islamic days of ignorance by Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, hafidhahu Allahu wa ra'ah wa ayyada. In this mas'ala, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimana Allahu wa iyyah, he mentioned al-mas'ala to al-rabi'a wa tis'oon, aspect number 94. He say, akhdhu al-bari bijurmati ghayrihi, blaming or holding accountable someone that is innocent for someone else's crime. Holding accountable someone that is innocent for someone else's crime. Anna min dinihim, from the ways of the people of Jahiliyyah, is أخذ الرجل بجريمة غيره. From the deen of the people of Jahiliyyah, it is that they used to hold accountable or held accountable a person for the sins of someone else. فأنزل الله تبارك وتعالى, in Allah the Most High, He revealed, ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى, in Surah Al-Fatir, ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى, that none will carry the load of the other one. In other words, no one will carry someone else's sins or someone else's crime. شيخنا شيخ صالح الفوزان حفظه الله, he say, من مسائل الجاهلية, from the aspects of the people of Jahiliyyah, he say, أنهم يأخذون الرجل, is that they used to take the individual, أي يعاقبونه, punishing him بسبب جرم غيره, because of someone else's fault. They will take a person and punish him because of someone else's fault. فأنزل الله تبارك وتعالى, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent, He revealed this verse in Surah Al-Fatir, as Sheikh Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab, he brought it istidlalan. ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى, and no one will be carrying the load or the sins of the other one. فالذي لم يحصل منه الظلم, أو فالذي لم يحصل منه ظلم, he said, the one that did not commit no crime, لا يؤخذ بالظلم أو بالظلم غيره, the one that haven't commit a crime should not be in any shape or form held accountable for the sin of someone else. حتى ولو كان قريب ابن عمك أو والدك وولدك, even if he is very close to you, let it be your cousin, ابن عمه, let him be his cousin, or his father and mother, meaning his parents, أو والده, his parents, أو ولدي, or his own children, then you should, the person, nobody should be blamed for the sin of someone else. He say, لا يجني جان إلا على نفسي. He say, that the one that perpetrated a crime, it is only to be coming back to him. The one that perpetrated the crime, he is the one that the crime should be coming back to him. إلا على نفسه. He say, ولا يؤخذ البر, and the person that is innocent should not be held accountable بجرمه أو بجرمة المعتدي, the person that is innocent should not be held accountable for the crime of the one that is the transgressor. فإذا أخذ غير المعتدي بعداوة المعتد فهذا ظلم وجرور لا يقرأ الإسلام. He say if the transgressor or the transgressor or the oppressor, he has been yani replaced for someone else in regard to the crime that is committed, he say that this itself is an oppression. This itself is an oppression.
Jazakallah khair. Akhi, we miss you, man. In your coffee.
If the oppressor is being replaced for someone else that has not committed the crime, the Shaykh Hafidhullah, he say فَهَذَا ظُلْمٌ, that this itself is an oppression. And he say وجرور, and it is a crime, it is an oppression. He say لَا يَقَرُّهُ الْإِسْلَامِ, Islam does not validate it, Islam does not recognize, Islam does not agree with this. That because a person, he committed a crime, that you're going to resort to someone else that is free, that itself is a crime. And Islam does not condone that action. Meaning that I transgress against Fulan. Tayyip. That instead of Fulan, and he coming back at me, but he will come back at my brother, Mathalan. That this itself is oppression. Because the crime was from, I committed it. So it was supposed to come back to me. Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan hafidhah, he say, فَالْآنْ وَالْآنْ فِي بَعْدِ الْبَوَادِ, in some of the villages or some of the places or some of the lands, إِذَا حَسَلَ اِعْتِدَاءَ مِنْ شَخْصٍ مِنْ قَبِيلَةٍ, if a crime has been perpetrated against somebody in the tribe, وَكَانَ هَذَا الشَّخْصٍ, and this individual, لَا وَزْنٌ لَهُ, he doesn't have no status in the tribe. That individual, he doesn't have no status in the tribe. He say, لَا يَقْتَصُونَ مِنْهُ, that they will not take the revenge on him. وَإِنَّمَا يَقْتُلُونَ, but rather they will kill someone else. أَوْ يَنْتَقِمُونَ مِنْ غَيْرِهِ, they will take their revenge on someone else. مِنْ قَبِيلَةٍ, from the same tribe. مِمَّنْ هُوَ أَشْرَفُ مِنْهُ, but not anyone, but someone that has a high rank among the tribe. Now let's say I'm the most insignificant of the tribe, and I committed a crime. So they will not, the other one that I committed a crime against, they will not hold me accountable for that, to punish me for that. But rather, if let's say he is the head of the tribe, or he is one of the elites of the tribe, مثلاً, then they will come back and sentence him for that crime that he has not committed, while he is very clean and very free from that crime. Right? So therefore, Ash-Shaykh Fawdan hafidhahullah, he say, and this is something that you find it today. And this is, when he mentioned that, وَالْآنَ فِي بَعْدِ الْبَوَادِ, that some of the place that you find this is barakallahu fikum, in reality. And more so in some of those lands, that the issue of Qabiliyyah is very strong. I'm talking about very strong. In Yemen, for instance, one of the brothers, alhamdulillah, he has related to us about an incident that was like this. There was in between the two tribes, a person had taken the life of one of those individuals in the tribe. But the retaliation was not in regard to the one that took his life, because the individual was not that, you know, has a lot of importance. So therefore they retaliated to someone else that has more importance in the tribe. And subhanallah, this was a brother, alhamdulillah, that used to be an imam in the masjid. And going back home to, alhamdulillah, to visit. And he got killed because of that. Because of someone else's crime that he has committed. He was not even there in the country when the crime was perpetrated. But because the one that killed, right, he didn't have no importance in the tribe. In him, he was important to the tribe. So they took his life. He said, وَأَعَزُّ مِنْهُ, or someone that has more of a status, more importance, more hierarchy. وَلَا يَأْخُذُونَ الْمُعْتَدِّ, and they will not care about the transgressor. The one that committed the crime, they don't care about him. وَإِنَّمَا يَأْخُذُونَ شَيْخُ الْقَبِيلَةِ, they will take the sheikh of the qabila. They will take, and here the sheikh of the qabila, it means not necessarily the oldest one in the qabila, but it means the one that has the most nobility in the qabila. Right? The one that has the most nobility in the qabila. So the term sheikh is given into three situations. The term sheikh is given into three situations. One, because of age. Thaniyan, al-ilm. هذا لا يسمى شيخ. ولكن بالنسبة العز في القبيلة هذا يسمى شيخ. ولو كان فقيرا. Right? ولو كان فقيرا. So the third one, the first one was that the person is sheikh because of the age. He is 60 and up. Thaniyan, because he is a knowledgeable person. عالم. عالم, that other ulama has acknowledged his scholarship. And thirdly, it is because that he is a sheikh because of his status in his tribe. Because of the status that he has in his tribe. Let's say he is the head of the tribe. Even if he is the age of Ibrahim, right? Then he will be called the sheikh. Because he is the head or the elite of the, he is seen as the elite of the tribe. So therefore, let us not be among those who use the term sheikh very loosely. The individual, he's not somebody in his tribe that like this. He's not knowledgeable and he's not of that age. We should not call him sheikh like this. But rather we call him by his kunya or by his name or whatever title that he has in his deserving. وَإِنَّمَا يَأْخُذُونَ شَيْخٌ أَوْ شَيْخًا وَإِنَّمَا يَأْخُذُونَ شَيْخًا, that they will take an elderly or someone that has nobility in the qabila. أو من له قيمة, or someone that has a great level of importance. Someone that has a high level of rank. He say, أو مقام في القبيلة, and he is someone that is very not, yani, given that stage, given that prompt, or given that barakallahu fikum, that which is the level state in that qabila. وهذا من فعل الجاهلية. So therefore, not holding accountable the transgressor, but yet to hold it against someone that is of free of any guilt, this is from the deen or from the actions of the people of Jahiliyyah. Na'am. Sure. Number one, he has to be knowledgeable. He has to be knowledgeable. And he is knowledgeable, and it's not me that say so-and-so is knowledgeable. Right? Because if I'm not knowledgeable, how will I determine somebody that is knowledgeable? Right? If I'm not a good mechanic, how would I testify that he's a good mechanic? I mean, you can come here, fix your brake, and you go. That doesn't mean he's a good mechanic. Right? Which is not anywhere. Number two, Abdul Rahman.